الله من الشيطان الرجيم ورتل القرآن ترتيلا.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته.
Good, everything is good with all of you. Okay. In this lesson, we are going to explore some important points which should be noted and remembered. Now, you can find on the top one word, yawma'idhin, and also yawmi'idhin. The word is the same, only a slight change in the third letter. The first two letters are ya and waw, and the third letter is meem. And in the first example, you can find meem with fatha. And in the second example, meem with kasra. Both words have appeared in the Holy Quran, and we recite during, you know, when we read the Holy Quran, text of the Holy Quran, we recite that. There is no change in the meaning. Sometime a change in the stroke does change the meaning, but sometime it just a change in the in strokes does not change any meaning. But we have to recite according to, you know, the construction and the right strokes which have been given. Now, in these three examples, which you can scan your mind and you can learn that these three examples have been taken from the last chapters of the Holy Quran in part 30. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم يومئذ تحدث أخبارها. Okay, can you tell me which surah is that? Just quick, because maybe you have. So yes, Surah Zilzal, yes. And next, Inna Rabbahum Bihim Yawma Idhil Khabir. Which surah is that?
Al-Adiyat.
Yes, well done. Surah Al-Adiyat. You see, when you just read, you scan your mind, if you have memorized that one small surah, you can quickly locate, find out where is that is in the text. ثُمَّ لَتُسْأَلُنَّ يَوْمَ إِذٍ عَنِ النَّعِيمِ. I give you one hint. This is the last verse of a chapter, of a surah, last verse of a surah. Surah Al-Takasur. So this is the last verse of surah. Okay. So the word yawma izin has come 69 times. The word yawma izin, including yawmi izin, has come altogether, that word. It has come 69 times in the Holy Quran, and first three examples have been given in front of you. So let's start with the ta'awuz. A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. Yawma idhin tuhadithu akhbaraha. Inna rabbahum بهم يومئذ لخبير ثم لتسألن يومئذ عن النعيم. حسن, you do this one.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم يومئذ تحدث أخبارها إن ربهم بهم يومئذ لخبير ثم لتسألن يومئذ عن النعيم.
عبد الرحمن.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم يومئذ تحدث أخبارها إن ربهم بهم khabir.
After rabbahum, meem sakin followed by ba. Okay, inna rabbahum, the second word is ending on meem sakin and the third word is starting with ba. Okay, so meem will be kept short or prolonged. Prolonged. Okay, do this one.
Inna rabbahum bihim yawma izil khabir.
Well done.
ثم لتسألن يومئذ عن النعيم.
As I mentioned that 69 times this word has come. Now 69 times in total and 67 times with the third letter meem with fatha. And when you reading the Holy Quran, it is high possibility and likelihood a person on the other two examples where the third letter carries only a kasra, it should also be pronounced and recited like a yawma izin with me with fatha. So we have to remember those things. Sometime in a flow, this point is ignored. But whatever the Arab and strokes have been given there, we have to follow that. And this is one example in Surah Hud, chapter 11, verse 67. And here you can find here, Yaw mi'izin. Yaw mi'izin, not Yaw ma'izin. Okay. Now, here starting from Falamma up to Al-Aziz, we will do this one. You can divide the text into two if you like, because that is a quite big from Falamma up to Yaw mi'iz.
فَلَمَّا جَاءَ أَمْرُنَا نَجَّيْنَا صَالِحًا وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مَعَهُ بِرَحْمَةٍ مِنَّا وَمِنْ خِزْيِ يَوْمِئِذٍ إِنَّ رَبَّكَ هُوَ الْقَوِيُّ الْعَزِيزُ. فلما جاء أمرنا نجينا صالحا والذين آمنوا نجينا صالحا والذين آمنوا معه برحمة منا ومن خزي يومئذ إن ربك هو القوي العزيز.
You will agree with me that in a flow of recitation, it is important to remember such words, and there are not so many. You know, when there are is 67 other examples, and only one, two examples are like that with the kasra, then is a likelihood that in a flow, a person can recite like the previous examples. So we have to be very, you know, mindful of that one. This is another issue. Why this meem has come with kasra? We know that this is because of harful char. You know, there is certain factors or conditions because of, you know, this kasra. But a common reciter does not know. So he has to remember for some certain example. Okay.
فلما جاء أمرنا نجينا صالحا والذين آمنوا معه برحمة منا ومن خزي يومئذ إن ربك هو القوي العزيز.
Okay, Alhamdulillah. Another example in Surah Al-Mu'arij, chapter 70, verse 12. This is only the second example. Two examples. One is in Surah Hud, and second one is in Surah Al-Mu'arij.
يُبَصَّرُونَهُمْ يَوَدُّ الْمُجْرِمُ لَوْ يَفْتَدِي مِنْ عَذَابِ يَوْمِئِذٍ بِبَنِيهِ.
يُبَصَّرُونَهُمْ يَوَدُّ الْمُجْرِمُ وَلَوْ يَفْتَدِي عذاب يومئذ ببنيه.
يسد يفتدي أو يقتدي. يف. Okay, do again. No problem. Yes.
يود المجرم لو يفتدي من عذاب يومئذ ببنيه.
Okay. The reference is there. You can open the, you know, the copy of the Holy Quran. Maybe a screen is a bit further. Our next word is تحتها الأنهار and تحتها الأنهار. And this example, Surah Al-Baqarah, chapter 2, verse number 26. Now, 6,348 verses altogether. And 36 verses where the word, you know, tahtiha or tahtaha has come. You know, this word is ta, ha, ta, ha, and alif. You know, these are five letters. And most of the time, it has come with al-anhar. And many, you know, for example, jannat in tajri min tahti al-anhar. As I mentioned, the total 36 verses, the word, this tahti al-anhar, or tahtiha or tahtaha has been mentioned. Now, 34 times it has appeared tahtiha lanhar, the third letter with kasra, tahtiha lanhar, starting from Surah Al-Baqarah, and another example we can find here is the last example in Surah Al-Bayyina, chapter 98, verse number 9. Again, jannatu adnin tajri min tahtiha lanhar. Okay. And only one time, only without after al-anhar, just tahtiha. The point I like to mention here, that when there is a flow of recitation and all the time a person is inclined and is required according to Arab, tajri min tahtiha al-anhar, there is only one example in the Holy Quran where this word has with fatha. And a person who is in the habit of the, you know, continuous recitation, is a likelihood and possibility that he also reads that word. One example which is in Surah At-Tawbah with Kasra on the third letter. Okay. So let's start with Surah Al-Baqarah.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم وبشر الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات أن لهم جنات تجري من تحتها الأنهار.
This is one example. Another example in Surah Al-Bayyina, chapter 98, verse number 9. And in between, there are so many examples, but that was the first one, and that is the last. Okay.
جزاؤهم عند ربهم جنات عدن تجري من تحتها الأنهار خالدين فيها أبدا.
Now, I will ask you to recite only one example. Okay, first, Hassan, you do this one.
وَبَشِّرِ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ أَنَّ لَهُمْ جَنَّاتٍ تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِهَا الْأَنْهَارِ.
Okay, Abdurrahman, you do the second.
جزاؤهم عند ربهم جنات عدن تجري من تحتها الأنهار خالدين فيها أبدا.
Okay, good. Now, this is the example where the word is not with kasra but with fatha, the third letter, تحتها الأنهار, not تحتها. And this is only one example, and we have to remember here.
وَأَعَدَّ لَهُمْ جَنَّاتٍ تَجْرِي تَحْتَهَا الْأَنْهَارُ خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا أَبَدًا ذَلِكَ الفوز العظيم وأعد لهم جنات تجري تحتها الأنهار خالدين فيها أبدا ذلك فوز العظيم
ذلك الفوز العظيم
ذلك الفوز العظيم
okay good this ذلك الفوز العظيم also similar sounding it's a very good example to find out because the you know the soft and then the فوز and then wa you know thick you know that is thick letters one of the those so is a good three words three similar sounding letters and a good for practice okay our next point to be remembered about the word fihi and fihi 124 times the word fihi has come and 123 times it is only with kasra and one example is with vertical kasra and it should be pronounced like there is a ya fihi and these are the four examples zalikal kitabu la raiba fihi hudal lil muttaqin fihi small you know the kasra simple kasra wazkuru ma fihi la'allakum tattaqun fihi with small kasra wattaqu yawma turja'un fihi ila allah thumma tuwaffa kullu nafsin ma kasabat wa hum la yuzlamun you know about any particular point about this last verse which is verse number 289 of surah al-baqara wattaqu yawman turja'una fihi ila allah in the history of the text of the holy quran it has some significance and importance according to one report I just quickly tell you according to one report this was the last verse revealed to our beloved master the holy prophet muhammad sallam okay this one wattaqu yawman turja'una anyway so these are the four example now here you can find that as I mentioned that 124 times this word fihi including fihi has been mentioned in the holy quran sometime out of 124 sometime one fihi in one verse you know only one example in one verse sometime two and this is one of the example surah al-baqara chapter 2 218 يَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنِ الشَّهْرِ الْحَرَامِ قِتَالٍ فِيهِ then again another example قُلْ قِتَالٌ فِيهِ كَبِيرٌ because of the shortage of time we are not reciting that one but you can you know just for the sake of knowledge this is another chapter 2 surah al-baqara 214 where the three times the fihi has come three times كَانَ النَّاسُ أُمَّةً وَاحِدَةً here فِي مَخْتَلَفُ فِيهِ again وَمَخْتَلَفَ فِيهِ and then fahad allah alladhina amanu lima ikhtalafu fi three times has come so that's making you know 124 and this is a rare example and when you know where the word fi has come together and this only one example in the holy quran fi in it okay so ahaqqu an taquma fi and then there is a stop pause fihi rijalun yuhibbuna an yatatakharu okay surah at-tauba chapter 9 verse 109 this is the point and this is the verse and this example should be noted and remembered because out of 124 this is the only example which is with vertical kasra and in a flow of the recitation where many examples more than 100 examples of fihi will have with kasra and we are not allowed to prolong more than 1 second there is a possibility that it should be recited like that but here according to the tradition transmitted to us the riwayat the chain of transmission here ha with the vertical kasra okay and it should be pronounced like there is a ya sakin on that one fihi longer than kasra and this is only one example surah al-furqan chapter 25 verse 17
yudha'af lahu al-'adhabu yawm al-qiyamati wa yakhlud
fihi muhana, stretching the voice, okay, fihi muhana, okay,
yudu'af lahu al-'adhab yawm al-qiyamati wa yakhlud fihi muhana.
يضاعف له العذاب يوم القيامة ويخلد فيه مهانا. يضاعف له العذاب يوم القيامة ويخلد فيه مهانا.
Okay, now this is the point to remember. This is the last ruku section of Surah Al-Furqan. Now, this is the word hubban and habban. Sometimes a change in a stroke does not change in the meaning at all. But sometimes a little change of stroke change in the meaning as well. And this is one example. The first one is linukhrija bihi habban wa nabata. Okay, this is verse number 16 of chapter 78, Surah An-Naba. And habban means grain. And hubban with dhamma, it means love. وَتُحِبُّونَ الْمَالَ حُبًّا حُبًّا جَمَّا. Hubban, love. And here the word du'afin with the fatha, dhamma, and du'afin with fatha. But there is no change in the meaning at all. And we have the true traditions about the pronunciation of this one. Here the word, the du'afin has come. Du'afin has come two times and du'afan at once. Basically, it has come three times in this verse. And in some copies of the Holy Quran, which I show you on the screen, this word has also been pronounced and is pronounced like with fatha, du'afin. Basically, du'afin means weakness. And if you pronounce like du'afin, it is also weakness. Does not change any meaning. But the two traditions are continued. Okay. I give you one example here. This is image of a copy of the Holy Quran, Yassan al-Quran style. Surah Ar-Rum, chapter 30, verse 55. Here, the word du'afin with dhamma. And in this copy of the Holy Quran, printed in the Middle East, you can find here, Allahu alladhi khalaqakum min da'afin. Again, thumma ja'ala min ba'di da'afin. It is pronounced like that. There are two traditions. Both are okay. Both are perfectly right. Okay, so we will do this one first.
الله الذي خلقكم من ضعف ثم جعل من بعد ضعف قوة ثم جعل من بعد ضعف قوة ثم جعل من بعد قوة ثم جعل من بعد قوة ضعفا وشيبة يخلق ما يشاء وهو العليم القدير.
Now the word three times, ضعفين, ضعفين and ضعفين, all with dhamma, okay, and meaning the weakness. Now we have another example in Surah Anfal, chapter 8, verse 67. Du'afin or du'afan, weakness. This word has come in the Holy Quran with fatha as well, and this is the example. Does not change any of the meaning. So the word du'afin or du'afan, both examples are, they can be traced from the text of the Holy Quran. So that both tradition with du'afin or du'afin are right, and the that tradition which practice da'afin with fatha, that word, and this is one example. وَعَلِمَ أَنَّ فِيكُمْ ضَعْفًا. Here,
الْآنَ خَفَّفَ اللَّهُ عَنْكُمْ وَعَلِمَ أَنَّ فِيكُمْ ضَعْفًا.
Okay, do this one and we conclude our lesson. Yes.
الآن خفف الله عنكم وعلم أن فيكم ضعفا.
الآن خفف الله عنكم وعلم أن فيكم ضعفا.
Okay, now Zishan, I think you do this. Yes, I'm going to start that one, that copy of the Holy Quran with Dhamma.
الله الذي خلقكم من ضعف ثم جعل من بعد ضعف قوة ثم جعل من بعد قوة ضعفا وشيبة يخلق ما يشاء وهو العليم القدير.
Okay, so that is the conclusion of lesson 41. So we have discussed about the yawm izin, no difference at all, but we have to remember those with the places of the Holy Quran. Then we mentioned about tahtiha lanhar and tahtaha lanhar, one example tahtaha lanhar, and also about the fihi, 123 examples fihi, and only one with vertical kasra, long fihi. We have to remember only one example, okay? And then the last one, the word du'afin and da'afin. No change in the meaning, but it's up to you, you know. Why I have mentioned this one, during tabligh, some non-Muslims, they object on certain, these practices. But there is no change in the meaning. This is a way of pronunciation of certain words in every language of the world. As I mentioned last, in that the same spelling, O-F-T-E-N, often and often. So both are okay and does not change any meaning, change in the meaning. Okay, so that is Tammat bil khair, kana Allahu ma'akum. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم ورتل